Hey everyone, I hope you had a good weekend. I figured I laid off for 2 days and I figured better do a little Twitch stream tonight, and then I'll upload this tutorial to YouTube a little bit later. And I've been watching UFO videos, so I figured let's make some kind of tectonic looking UFO tower looking things in the middle of the desert. Let's just get started. So we have Rhino opened already. I'm just going to type in grasshopper and double click on my perspective, just bring in a higher window. I'm going to type in, we're going to do it kind of randomly and make it relatively quick. Type in populate 3D. I'm going to need a box. I'm going to use the center box here. Give it some dimensions. I'll just do the typical 15, 15, 15. Space them out just like so. Perfect. There we go. Gotta show the desktop, don't we? Ooh, crazy. Okay. So from here, we're just going to populate the region of that box here. That's going to fill the volume. The only reason I use populate 3D here, instead of populate geometry just populates the actual geometry, not fills the volume up. So that's the reason there. And then from here, I'm going to give it a number. That's how many plates we'll be working with. If my idea is correct and I don't mess it up. And then we're going to just duplicate that populate 3D down below, give it a different seed. So there's slightly different points within the volume. I'll just bring these all forward because that's our common controls. Line that up to there. And then from here, what I'm going to do is just type in line. We're going to start to set up our line with 2 points. Wrong line. And then from here, what we're going to start to set up basically is just make a network of curves and lines that will eventually extrude up and or down, whichever, and hopefully we get a cool result. So I might make this just how should we do this? Every time we bring the volume of the box higher, the lines start to change, and I actually want to ex kind of accentuate like angles. So I'm gonna leave it 15, 15, 15 for now, and then we'll just scale it non-uniformly based on the volume. I feel like my mouse is not clicking today quite as well as it should be. There we go. Volume, that'll give us our volume centroid. And then from here, I'm just going to type in 1.2555. Just give us a little bit extra control. All right. And then we can hide all this stuff just to see what we're looking at. All right. And from here, we can start to kind of accentuate that a little teeny bit more. So I'm kind of digging the really crazy angles happening. All right. And so now I'm just going to do some really easy and random stuff. So if I type in random split, put it into our non-scaled curves here, our non-uniform scaled curves. And then I might want to do it 4 times. So boom. And from here, do another one, put it into B. So that's basically I'm going to split these all up into different groups. I'm going to flatten it just for to make sure we're actually getting the different groups. I can hide all these. And then what I'm going to do is type in curve, and I'm not going to plug it into anything right now because we'll be able to copy and paste it and make the workflow a little teeny bit easier without having to plug in a lot of things all at once. So if I type in Z. We might add some variations to this. I'm not sure how long this stream's gonna last, but just to make it a little bit more exciting. 15 PID. That's gonna be our first group here. And the reason why I put curve in there and just didn't put it in sequentially is because we might want to break this up a little bit later. So I'm gonna type in there. That'll be our first path. I can take this, plug it down to here. That'll be our second. We can add more if we want. more in the Z direction for extrusion. Type in curve again, bring it down again. This one we can bring up just a little bit more. Boom. And then we can bring this up to the max, just see what it looks like. I might tone these down just a little teeny bit. And then, great, so that's kind of what I'm looking for the most part. I might reduce it because we have 55 different lines in there, and you know, we can always add more. But what I'm going to do is actually just random reduce, and let's organize these a little bit using the alignment tool here in Grasshopper. You do all those. Okay, let's make sure these aligned a little bit better. Just like so. I don't think these are perfectly done. More of these. Drives me crazy when these aren't straight. Okay. So from here, I'm going to random reduce all these extrusions we just made in one single list. So we're not taking away from one particular group. So we can type in random, go up to random reduce, make sure it's flattened because we want to keep them all. We want to keep them all in the same group, like so. Plug them all in. Perfect. And this will be orange, but we have to give it a number. So we have 55 currently, so I'm going to just type in 55, and then we should end up with no extrusions, or one. Oh, we have 57 in the actual number right now, so there should be two, okay? So let's bring that number down, and let's give it a new seed, so we can start to play with, like, just because we reduced 38, we can have, you know, a billion different scenes. So that's starting to look pretty cool for the most part. That's pretty cool. Okay, and then from here, what I'll do is let's just type in, we can mesh it, make it a little bit easier. And go into our Weaver Bird tab, just add some thickness so it seems a little bit more real in the renderings. That's pretty thick because it's sitting at a meter, I believe. So I'm going to just type in 0.55, make it a little bit thinner. Looks pretty cool. You know what I actually might do? Let's take all the actual reduction there. Let's add some variation to how thick they are. So maybe at the bottom, they're pretty thick, and then at near the top, they get relatively thin. So I'll just copy that down four times. And then just apply the mesh B-rep to our extrudes. And then I'm going to line all these up as per usual. Line those up, get them a little organized. There we go. And then what we can do is actually just bring them all back into here, just like so. And then we can hide those. There we go. And so I said at the bottom, let's make them a little bit thicker. Maybe we can go beyond one. And let's bring up the 9 for now. Make them a little bit thicker at the bottom. Make them a little bit thick near the midway. So I'm just adjusting the numbers just to get the look we want. Maybe I'll bring this down or bring it up again. And from here, make those pretty shallow. So those are really thin. That's looking pretty cool. Alright, so if we bake that out, see what it looks like kind of in render view. Getting these nice kind of shard-like glass broken objects for now. So one thing I wanted to play with is let's try to break up some of them. So if we have randomly a few lines through here, I might just randomly split them again into two different lists, break them up and shatter them, and then from there start to make even more little teeny subdivisions throughout here. I know there's a lot of different ways you can do that, but I kind of want to just try it with shatter for now. So I'm going to bring this out, type in random reduce again, through here. And then each one will eventually go through here, but we're going to take this one aside and we're going to divide it out. Every curve that's in this list in the A. I'm going to flatten this, even though I don't have to, just habit. I'm going to type in 25 for the divided curve plug. And from here, I'm going to type in shatter. And we're going to shatter these curves with these tangent points, lowercase t. And so we should have a lot of them. Yep. And then from here, I'm going to do a call pattern. And I'm going to right click on P, go down to set multiple booleans. I'm going to take out these two middle true falses. So I don't think my mouse is a little beaten up today. Okay, from here, I'm going to flatten this list. And these should be dotted lines if we're lucky. Maybe we're not so lucky. There we go. We didn't need to flatten. All right, so this looks pretty sweet. So from here, we're going to just plug and play, place this call pattern into our random split again. This might slow down our computer just a little bit, but that's all right. We're going to plug in the B that we had originally, so we get some solid point or planes into there again. There we go. Now we're starting to get some pretty cool little details happening. And we can bring down the amount of those as well. All right, and then if we bake out this, let's see what it's starting to look like. That's looking pretty cool. Yeah, so I'm thinking just kind of white modeling for these, for the rendering. That's looking pretty sweet. Now one thing I might do is actually scale it slightly in one direction. So if we were to take this and just type in scale 1D just as a test, scale it in that direction. I want to see what that looks like. Nice and slim. I think I'll do that in the grasshopper definition. So to speed this up just a little teeny bit, I'm going to join all these meshes. Just like so, flatten it, just make sure everything's handled in there. And then basically I'm going to type in bounding box again. We're going to find the volume off of that bounding box. Just so we have a central rotation. And I'm going to type in rotate based off of the centroid of the volume. We're going to right click on A on our rotate to change it to degrees instead of radians. I'm going to type in 45. And from here, we're going to scale it non-uniformly. And if we look here, it should be rotated. There we go. Good rotation. Looks like we're going to scale it a little teeny bit, smaller in the Y direction. Based off of that volume centroid and that geometry. And I'm going to hide the rotate for now so we can see how far we're actually getting it to be. There we go. I think that's pretty sweet. All right, I'm going to move these around so everyone can kind of see. Excellent. So relatively short definition here, but I think we'll get some really cool results when we get to Lumion. So what I'm going to do is just bake this one out. That'll be our first. So I'm going to work with three of them. I'll just move this over here. And then the cool thing is we'll get different variations of this just based on the populate 3D at the beginning. That's why we put a seed on there. So if I just take this and move it up to any number higher than the one we had previously, we'll get completely different variations. Bake that one out. And from here, I'll put that one a little bit further back so they're not fully symmetrical. Then we'll go back to the beginning of our grasshopper definition. And let's go up maybe. Perfect. There we go. So this will be our three kind of weird block tower things. What I might do is just rotate them out just a little bit so we show more of the broad side of them. This one I'm not too sure about the front. Let's see what the back looks like. I kind of like this one a little bit more, just as the key piece. So I'm going to unrotate that one, bring it up, move this one over, rotate it, bring it up. There we go. So that's looking pretty cool. All right, so I'm thinking this is going to be some sort of desert landscape for these. And so I'm just going to type in bounding box to start to make a quick landscape. I'm thinking these are going to be kind of just these light white figures in the background here. So let's give it kind of a big space. And then from here, I'm just going to center some stuff. What I typically try to do is in Rhino, already try to have the view in mind that I'm going to do as the kind of the main shot here. Okay, so something that semi-fills the page, a little bit centered. Okay, and then from here, I'm just going to lock these meshes down. Bring up the landscape so these are touching the ground just a little teeny bit. Then from here, type in rebuild. 75, 75, 75 looks good to me. And if we go up to our select tab up here, we can put the points on. Get our little paintbrush selection tool. Basically from here, I'm just going to start moving a few occasional points, starting kind of small, so we get some nice little ravines happening. Just like so. And then I can move those up just a little bit. That'll be kind of the first sequence to our desert floor. Now I'm going to make a bigger one, just so we have some layering happening. Looking pretty cool. Make it a little bit bigger. And from here, let's do a much bigger one. So if we hold shift and move our mouse up, you increase the brush size. So I'm just tracing kind of what we created a little bit before, maybe some overlapping, and then we'll get some nice ridge effects happening in here. Perfect. Let's bring that up even higher. So these things are really cased in this weird landscape. Okay, let's go over shaded mode. And from here, I'm going to smooth it. Just a little bit, and that might be a little bit too much. I kind of want to keep a little bit of it. There we go. Let's do that one more time. Same. There we go. Not too sure about this portion here, so I might just do it once again. That's looking better. Yeah. That's pretty sweet. And then let's add some water through here. I think water is always good for an image. All right, so I'm just going to go as if these things were built for the landscape. Not intrusive. So that would be our first little canal. Our second through it. Kind of clear some areas up so let's get some hint of desert through here. Bring that a little bit lower. And then from here, I'm just going to right click on this surface creator. Just give it a plane. Drop it down just a little bit, just like so. There we are. And from here, for Lumion, we need to just give it some material. So I'm gonna just make the water water, make the landscape rock. And then if I unlock our grasshopper creation, I'm just gonna change them for now just to concrete. Basically from here, we're ready to export. So let's make it a Collada file. I have one saved already. Perfect. Now if we go over to our Lumion, we're just going to import from speed 1. This should load up relatively quick. It's not super complicated. Just like so. Bring it up above the plane so we can start to see what we're working with. There we go. Now we can apply some Lumion materials. So those are looking really cool already. So I'm kind of excited for it. All right, let's change the water to water, natural. And let's see what blue ocean is. I feel like this water would be kind of rushing through the desert here. And then for rock, see what we can get here. That's not quite what I'm looking for. Let's zoom in just a little bit. Make sure that's kind of desert, but it's more soil. That's kind of desert. This is more desert. And these are pebbles. We don't want that. Let's try rock, actually. It looks cool. Gotta look at the bigger picture, though, here. So, no luck. It's a scale thing. That could be it. Wish we could go higher on that. Alright, so let's do some weathering on the rock here so we can get some more variation. The edges really shift. Alright. Perfect. And then for the actual main objects, let's play between all these. I wonder if we make them stone. Be pretty cool. Bring up the scale on them. Get a nice kind of smooth surface. Looks pretty sweet. Okay, now we just add some objects. I didn't really plan for scale, so I'm a little scared these might be a little bit too big. They're really, really big. So I'm going to take this whole model. We're going to scale it down just a little teeny bit. I'm going to have to mess with some stuff here in a bit, but I think that's looking a little bit more appropriate, so yeah, that's better. All right, so it's the desert, so not a lot of water, except in our imaginary scene here, but basically I'm going to add some just kind of logs sitting, a couple dead trees. This place supported life just a few years back, or however long ago. There's actually clusters. Yep. So, this might be too many, but we'll just see what happens. So, since there are some, kind of desert looking plants as well, so some life is still here. Cactus. Not that weird. And then from here, just a couple cacti through here in the background. Cool to have some dead animal skulls or something in this in these libraries for Lumion. A little morbid, but that's all right. And just a few of these little low-lying plants. And then I might add some grass, just so it kind of looks a little bit to life. Not a lot. Just around the edges of the water, and kind of float them up to some areas. Just some. Ground here. And I might add some ivy rolling up these structures as well. See how it looks. There's just a couple things around here, so it looks like there's a little bit of life in the foreground. Perfect. Looking pretty cool so far. And I see there's a little land bridge here, so maybe we'll add a person really quickly. Let's see. Someone walking. Let's just add a bikini girl. There we go. Just in the middle of the desert, walking by these weird forms, and a bikini. Perfect. And then let's see how big the boats are this time. Super big, so let's leave it out. And let's add maybe some birds. I'm just gonna put these just about everywhere. Now they're on the ground plane, so what we want to do is actually move them. Towards the view here. I'm gonna bring them up. Now, if this texture on the ground isn't working, we're gonna take it out, try something different. Not sure how well it'll look. Might need to add some rocks in the overall scene. Alright, something kind of red. So the hotkey for that is hold L to scale it. It should automatically bring stuff in randomly, so. Just enough. Maybe one big one out in the water. Lower. Okay. Not really match the scene, but we'll see what it renders out like. Okay, from here, I'm going to click on the material. I just want to see what leaves would look like on here. If they ever show up. There we go. So I think that's pretty cool, as if they're collecting water from the ground. I'm going to spread that pattern out just a little teeny bit so we get some more variation. Bring the spread up quite a bit bigger. That's looking pretty sweet. And I'm just going to bring that ground plane just a little bit lower so we're not going crazy. Oop. That's our spread pattern. We want that up. There we go. And ground plane. Alright, that looks pretty good to me. Certainly slows down the computer. Okay. So I'm going to hit OK, save our changes, and we're going to go to Photo, pick out our view that we're liking, Custom Style, those leaves on the surface are crashing, all this, so I might take them off just for now. And play with them later. Alright, we're gonna just bring the spread down. This should run a lot smoother. There we go. Nice. Okay. So let's go back to Photo, Custom Style. We're gonna do Realistic. From here, hit Camera, 2-point perspective, so we have nice straight lines. This is actually looking pretty decent if it renders out nicely. I'm going to add a sun so we can get some really nice shadows. And, or maybe we could maybe use real skies. See what it looks like. Sometimes this is really good. Sometimes it, I don't know, kind of lacks. We have some floating rocks here, so we'll change that in just a minute. Change the focal length so maybe we get more of the view. More of a flatter shot, maybe, or bring it closer. Right over the water, that could be really cool, and then we don't have to worry about the background being kind of a bad texture map. Okay, so that looks pretty sweet. Nice. Okay, I'm just going to camera real quick. This looks like some nice shadows happening through here. I don't know if we're perfectly aligned here. Like it? Okay, so we'll save it. Alright, and we'll render it out. Go to our folder. Okay. Perfect. We'll see what it goes as. The boring part of the tutorial, watching a render go. Looks pretty cool. I do wonder if we put the leaves back on. That'll slow it down, but I wonder if we do it with larger size leaves. That brings up the, that brings down the number of actual leaves there if we have big ones. Okay. For that, there we go. So the leaf size will make them pretty big. Okay, and let's bring them up higher. Bring our spread up. Okay. Hit okay. Computer's slowing down quite a bit. Alright, and then we just go back to our original view. I think we should put some rocks in here and maybe some dead trees in the background. But I just want to see what that's rendering out like. So let's override our previous one. Okay. Really slowing down everything. Okay. Looking. It's still rendering, folks, don't worry. That's looking pretty neat. Those leaves really slow down everything. Okay, well, maybe we'll turn it off, play with lighting, and then go back to them for kind of a finalized view. Just speed things up. Wish it wasn't so slow. Doesn't seem super complicated. All right, so let's just turn down our ground level. We're at 42.8, if I can remember. Perfect. Okay, so that's pretty quick. Hit OK. And we're going to add some rocks kind of where we were at. Let's just put in that same one. Just like that. Maybe a pretty big one, small, medium. Put one in the water again. Couple more. Nice. That one down. I believe this rock is floating. That's not real. Okay. And set some quick little plants in here. Kind of a cacti in the foreground there. Got the plants over. Get our grass back. That's a few of them. Yeah, just a little bush too. That's pretty big for just a little one. So just scale it. And put another one. One there. One more. Kind of looks desert. Alright. And then we need to find those dead trees again. Put in a cluster. Perfect. And I noticed when we were rendering previously, there was quite a few of them are missing areas. So let's act like this whole area was a really vast green vegetated state, but for some reason now it's just rock. Alright. And I'm gonna bring those birds just a little bit higher. So, I notice they're all flying at the same height, which isn't necessarily realistic at all. So, let's just select a few. Put them lower. Okay. So if we look backwards just a little bit, this is better. All right, looking cool. Sweet. So we'll just go back to our original. That looks a lot better. So got some nice foreground objects happening. Rocks not floating. And I'm just going to change with the sky real quick just to see if we can get anything that might look just a little bit better. This would be nice if we had lights in the scene, but we don't. This might look a little bit too dark. Looks nice, but I don't think it's what we're looking for. We can try morning. That looks pretty nice. Let's try to get the original shadows we had. Alright, let's do a test render. Now this one should go relatively quick. A little dark. And I kind of want some more clouds in there. And let's do one more. And then I think we can finish this up. I think that's it. I see a floating rock right here that I'm going to just change a little teeny bit. I'm going to just move actual camera up a little bit so we have some gap between our closest tower. Alright, so let's fix up that rock. Let's bring it a little bit lower, just like that. I'm going to bring this one just a little bit lower, this one too, so I don't have anything floating. And then let's do the ivy again. And we'll hit the render button one last time and see where we're at. Okay. Cool. Hit OK on there. Go to render. Oh, shoot. I was going to add some fog in the background. Let's do that real quick. Oh, that damn ivy. Really slow. Okay. There we go. It might be stuck. There we go. Alright. Maybe horizontal clouds would do it for us. Got a deep fog. Come on. I can't believe it's this slow. It's not that many leaves. Alright. Let's put some fog. Not that dense. Brightness just a little bit. And the fall off. Might be going the wrong direction. Let's bring up the density just one more time. Essentially what I'm trying to do is just kind of block out kind of those dead trees so these become more of the focal point. So I think that's pretty cool. Looks like it's about ready to storm in this scene. And I think we'll have it Right. Wow. So while this renders out, you're probably watching this on YouTube. So hopefully you subscribe. Twitch, I'm gonna try to do it every other day, or maybe once every 2 days, just so we don't exhaust, some of the design kind of process. I'll try to advertise it a little bit more on my Instagram when I'm gonna be doing it. Still looking for a proper setup with a mic, so there's not a lot of background noise. But yeah, it'll be getting there. I'm gonna try to do a little bit better job of editing for YouTube, and hopefully we'll really try to build this all up. So this looks like pretty much what it's gonna render out like. Kind of some weird, almost jagged, alien-looking forms out in the middle of nowhere, and it was just a bunch of random lines. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this, and I'll be doing more soon. Have a good one.